done? Why can't time go any faster? The ticks of the classroom clock makes my heart pound faster and faster. Seems like my feet demand to dance on the dance floor. My hands keep ripping the sheets of paper I've found inside my desk into tiny bits. As I gaze the study clock that strikes 3 to 2, the sound of footsteps approach me. And here she stood, in front of my desk, tucking her arms, cross eyebrows that matches her frown, staring at me in this distressful look. I wonder what makes her this scary. Oh no. Yes, Miss Tini Surtini? Anning, please repeat what I said. Please repeat what I said. No. I mean before what I just said. Please repeat what I said. Ah! After school, I demand you to meet me. Guess what happens next? All students pack their books and stationery quietly and tidily in their bags, followed by cleaning eraser remains, tidying their uniform, and up on their feet to pray. And no, this is what actually happened. Class suddenly turned into a circus. I leaped and danced under this artificial snow made of paper. Woohoo! Putting back my books and other stuff I took out before, in a rush, dragged my bag to the door until bang! I saw Miss Tini holding a wooden 90-centimeter ruler near the whiteboard, commanding us to go back to our seats and saying no one should leave until she says so. After saying our prayer, we made a line which moved towards Miss Tini to give her greetings. This queuing is such a waste of time, I murmured. Then my world begins as I stepped out my classroom door. Boo-hoo-hoo, miserable me. The moment I place my feet outside, a mob of anxious faces charge from the opposite direction. Stuck in the crowd, I can hear people shouting, "No pushing! Move! Make way, 9th graders coming through!" I suppose these are my seniors, curious to see their tryout results pinned on the information board, hanging on the end of the corridor. Fidgeting my way out of this riot, I was held by bigger postures, causing my shoulders to bump on big, heavy bags they were carrying. Great! Can this get any worse? I sighed. Suddenly, my eyes caught on a figure, leaning against the wall of my classroom, checking his watch as his head turned left and right, looking as he was waiting for someone. It was him! My crush! A fire of jealousy leapt inside. Oh, who is he waiting for? I murmured. Unexpectedly, the moment when our eyes meet happens! His eyes grew wider. Then he started to walk towards me. Panic and confused as I felt my heart beating like a drum, I ran to the lobby and went outside, ignoring the ones I bumped and crashed. I head straight home on a cycle rickshaw. I hope I'm not late.
Anning, we thought you won't come. What took you so long?
Sorry, well, I was getting out of class when... Oh, this can wait. Come on, it's about to start. We were in the field where the Indonesian flag was flying high in the sky. I can hear the crowd shrieking, calling names, singing their calls with joy. This time, the competition is not only about winning or losing, but the judges will also score the teamwork and solidarity of the teams. So, we decided to wear the same attributes, from head to toe. Oh, and the game we're about to play? Berabat Jengkol, one of the traditional Sinanese games from Indonesia. a game which needs strong legs, good balance, and great teamwork. However, unfortunately, I screwed it. We planned to wear the same colored t-shirt and blue school pants or skirt, but clumsy me, I left my bag, which I put my t-shirt, at school. There was no time to run home, no chance to turn back. At the end, Andy, Dara, Benno, and I wore our school uniform. When the MC on the speaker called out, "Desa Suka Bhakti," we knew it was our time to shine. All teams behalf of the classes may enter the Kumba Arena. Right leg, guys, I made sure. Right leg. Ben at the front, having the biggest posture among us, tucks his right leg back, making a 90 degree angle. Followed by me on the right side, Andy at the back, and Dara on the left, forming a perfect circle. When the whistle blows, we jumped on our left leg to the right, singing, "Perepet jengkol jajahen." The four of us tried to keep balance and to jump and land on the same moment. Until suddenly, I can't hold on any longer, cried Dara. "Hang on, at any moment they'll fall before us." "Perepet jengkol jajahen." Oh my god, is that unexpectedly? Because I caught a glimpse of my crush, our team tumbled first. And that means we lost. It doesn't matter. At least we got 2015's best team, right? Aneng, that boy looks like the one you talked about all the time, Dara exclaimed. And yes, he doesn't only look like, it's him, my crush. I wonder why he came here. Looks at my direction. He waves his hand, approaches me, and calls my name. Aneng, I think this is yours. Handling a bag consisting of red t-shirts of mine. Clap along if you feel like a